All right, welcome back. Let's get another perspective to the raging debate over the NSAS campaign. Now, I've been joined on the program from Ondo by Nelson Ekwujimi, who is a political affairs analyst and, of course, a civil society leader. He joins us via Skype. Nelson, thank you very much for joining us on the program. Do you want to see an end to SARS, or you want that police unit reformed?
Well, the truth of the matter is that, like we always say in this climb, that cutting of the head is not the solution to headache. I believe that what we should be clamoring for in this society today, due to the dysfunctionality of the SARS as an agency of the Nigerian police as an institution, is the reformation of that, you know, that unit of the police force. Because whether you like it or not, the SARS operatives, the dysfunctionality or their conduct is symptomatic of the dysfunctionality that has bedeviled every strata of our society. So I will be the last person that will join the call to ban SARS or to end SARS. Rather, I will be more concerned with, you know, the reformation of SARS, because SARS was set up to achieve a particular purpose. And if it is deviating from that goal for which it was set up, it bears on the society as well as those saddled with that responsibility to reform the unit, rather than for anybody to call for the sack or the ban or end SARS.
I mean, you're quite right. SARS was set up for a particular purpose, but some people are arguing that that purpose has long been achieved. And so why keep the bud? Why keep that unit of the force? But is that your opinion?
Absolutely not. Crime is an indispensable part of the society. And you and I know very well the role SARS has played, you know, in combating armed robbery in this country today. And as we speak, armed robbery is a crime that is still prevalent in our society. And, you know, in combating armed robbery, SARS has, you know, if you look at the available statistics, they have lived up to their billing, even though we recognize that there are some challenges. So if SARS has deviated from that noble objective of its being set up to combat armed robbery in the society as a unit of the Nigerian police force and straying into abuse and brutality of citizens, I think we should look at that area where SARS is failing and try to address that, you know, that part of their functions. The other part where they are set up, I don't think anybody can fault the performance of SARS in that regard. So for me, anybody saying that the Special Anti-Robbery Squad, whether at the federal level or at the state level, had achieved its goal, I think that person must be an analyst in Wonderland.
Now, part of the problem here is that most times, because I also agree with you that, look, SARS has no doubt done a lot, but you have a few bad eggs, you know, within. And the problem that a lot of people have is that, look, when some of these bad eggs are actually caught, the police authority do almost nothing about it. I mean, you just hear they get arrested, and after a while, you hear nothing again. Now, when you continue to have a situation like that, then what you're having now across the country, this protest we're seeing across the country, would be the end result, because, you know, those few bad eggs will definitely give that unit a very terrible name. And what you would get is what we have today, where people are calling for an end to SARS.
Yes, I agree with you. But the truth of the matter is that SARS, like every institution or every human endeavor, there's always the bad eggs. But if we are blaming SARS for its abuse of citizens' rights as well as brutality, I think the society is also culpable, because we've had numerous instances or incidences where people's rights have been abused, and for them to take it up, they have refused to perform their own responsibility with that regard. I'm a living witness to some instances. I can give you an example. There was a time I was at Area G police station in Lagos, where a friend to the then divisional crime officer reported that he was molested by some operatives of SARS or the police. And the area command, the DCO, was very interested in that case. And he told his friend that, look, we need to stop this abuse by our men. I'm interested in reforming the Nigerian police. And lo and behold, the man said, no, I don't want anything. Just leave them. Let them go. So we have cases like that where citizens, right, when they are abused, they will not take it further. They will not report officially, because those are the aim of affairs, sends out these operatives to perform the functions. And it is the feedback from the citizenry that will enable the authorities to know if SARS is doing right or not, just like we are having now. Also, I think the authorities at the policing institution are also culpable, because a lot of times when operatives of SARS are involved, you know, in misconduct, we don't get to see them being punished the way it's supposed to go. So it's a two-way traffic. We should blame the authorities, and also the society also has its own blame, because a lot of times people don't take it further than when they just come on the, onto the social media and make the report. Even some, in making the report at the social media, when the authorities take up the cue from the social media and want to act on that abuse or infraction on the citizen's right, the complainant will be nowhere to be found. And you and I know very well that when there's no complainant in a case, the case is as good as dead.
And we've also seen situations where citizens themselves have actually used the SARS to oppress other citizens as well.
Absolutely. You know, it's a, that's why I said it's a two-way affair. The society itself is culpable in, you know, in the misconduct of SARS. Because if the society is also up and doing, it will keep the authorities in charge of SARS on their toes. But in as much as the authorities of SARS also are culpable, the society is also an accomplice. Because if your right has been abused, it bears on you to look at some mechanisms through which you can seek redress. And even at the level of the policing institution, the SARS unit, you also, at times, you'll be shocked that even if you want to take up the matter, the mechanism for you to interface and be able to report appropriately, I can tell you for a fact that it is absolutely absent. That even when you are reporting, at the end of the day, nothing happens. The officers, we have seen these videos. Even these videos that we have seen of the abuse, why can't the policing institution as a body try and identify those operatives and use them, you know, as an example to tell the society that, look, we are doing something in this regard. So we need your support and cooperation to do more. When you find officers of this institution going outside their mandate, it is our collective responsibility together, because those in charge of the unit, you know, cannot be everywhere. They cannot see everything. It is the citizenry through their interface with the operatives that will be able to keep the authorities abreast of what is happening. Oh, you have sent your man to go and collect, you know, 10 cars. At the end of the day, the man has taken 15 cars. If the society does not report back, the authorities will not get that feedback. So these authorities at the policing institution must create a viable and functional feedback mechanism that will engender public confidence, you know, with regards to the reforming SARS.
Very quickly now, before I let you go, what kind of reforms would you want to see?
Yes, I want to see a reform that will involve, you know, an introspection into the curriculum, the curricula of the SARS as a unit. What is their training? What is the mindset? You know, I also like to see a setup of effective feedback or communication mechanism between the society and, you know, and the policing institution, such that they will be able to, at every point in time, they will be able to exchange notes. That will keep even the operatives on their toes, because I would know that as a SARS operative, if I'm going out on a function that I've been legitimately assigned to do, that, you know, my bosses are not the only one watching me, that the society is also watching me, that if I go against the law, then I'll face the appropriate sanctions.
All right. Nelson Ekwujimi, thank you very much for your time and for joining us on the program.
It's a pleasure. Thank you for having me.
Thank you very much. Well, that's how much we can take on the program this week. We thank you very much for watching. But if you want to make further contributions, you can do so on our various social media platforms. Thanks once again for watching. I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.